So our little chip arrived, and let's see if we can pick this guy up. So let's recall what we have to do. So I remember we need to put a chip, and we need to put it where? Let's see where we needed to put it. Yeah, we need to remove this chip and put a replacement of this chip. I never had a confirmation as to why I needed to. It was one of the logical things to do at this stage, to replace this IC. Okay, so let's do that then. Let's put some flux, and here we go. One thing is that I remember what there was, whether there was a coil there or not. Probably there was, I think. Airflow to 60, maximum 10, ring of magic. Let's bring wick and solder. So we don't even know if this chip we're going to replace with is good or not. Okay, that chip there got moved. Okay. Right. It's our new chip. Alright, how do we get this guy to stay? Okay, kind of, oh, you can see, alright, here we go. Let me get that chicken properly first. Alright. Alright, that will be it. Now one thing is, I don't remember if there was a coil there or not. Quickly review the video, 1 second. Right, so I just find what we're looking for. So there was an inductor here, this was it. Okay, let's put that in. Which should be just a straightforward process. Okay, great. Now, is it a good idea to test it, plug it in? And I don't even know what I'm looking for to see if it's working or not. So I do have this, which connects here. Okay. Okay, so that's the ammeter arisen from the death. Okay. Let's see if it will charge the battery, out of curiosity. I just got a USB output. This guy has a mind of its own. Can't work with this. It's a space of shish. Alright. I'll get a power tester and use the USB ammeter to tell me what's going on. Got another one here, but I'm having trust issues with these guys now. 0.016, 0.015. No, pretty much nothing. Even here I can't see how much amp it's pulling, charging my phone, okay. Bizarre. So there's actually no difference. Let's reflow that chip just to be sure that it has been soldered on properly. Yeah, definitely. That's improperly. No issues there. We've got a problem, one second. Just can't seem to get a proper charging going. It's driving me crazy a little bit. No. Okay, I understand the problem I'm doing. Alright, Jesus, okay. Okay. That's USB input, okay. Input. Now, finally, I can see the phone being charged. Yep, that's fine. 0.117 amps. Let's see here now. Huh, 0.018. 0.016. That's that. Now we'll discharge the battery, which I doubt it will. Same. 0.017. Okay, maximum, no difference. Okay. Which means the chip I replaced is not the chip that is faulty. Let's remove the other cap. Oh, gee. I should have opened this guy up. I didn't open him up. Yeah. Could have been a simple one all along. Seven, six, five, six. Power amplifier, I see. Okay. So we're gonna take that out without damaging. Maybe I'll grab it differently, I'll try and grab it this way. All right. And just check that diode, see if it is destroyed. No, okay. They're fine. Okay. We'll order this and then we'll continue. So our chip has finally come in for the Samsung, so let's fix that up. So that chip there had exploded. We've got 10 of them. Now let's figure out the right way to put them in. Okay, let me quickly review the old video. Be right back. Okay, so this is actually the correct orientation. Let's go ahead and put some flux. Yeah, and this is a new one. Looks like it's pulled out of another unit. That's what you get sometimes from AliExpress. These are pulled out from dead mobile phones. Okay, so that's all I want to do. Give it a nice clean touch. Okay. So will this unit power on? I have no idea. Feel like checking again the recording, eh? Yeah, that's correct. Okay. Yeah, I have to put everything back later on. I mainly want to see the voltage going up. If the voltage does go up, then my job is complete. I'll reassemble by watching the videos. Yeah, we'll have to be all glued back and everything else. Five volts. No change at all. So there's definitely a issue somewhere around there. And without the battery connected and the LCD, what is the reaction? Same reaction. Same reaction. So we can double check our work, make sure this chip is in properly. Now I've got a very large nozzle on this. I'm going to change that on the hot air gun. It's not good. It will move the other chips as well. Alright, that's gotta be in. The diode next to it could have an issue. So let's check that. .24 in this way. And I'm not sure if that's normal. I wonder why these are blue. Looks nice. But these guys are showing to be shorted, or are they meant to be like that? Okay, that's ground. Let me get a ground. Yeah, they're all going to ground. And that's a problem. Now, could it be because their chip is bad? There's actually a problem. So ideally, let's remove this chip and see where the short is. Ground. Yeah, there is a short there. Yeah, something here is still shorted. So we also need to find that out, okay. Let's bring the schematics for this. Will 510 be similar? Any board model numbers I can use? T510 is similar, okay. I'm looking for my chip. The one that we've got. Six, five, six. Try 531. Five one seven, 515. This is a completely different board. Oh, I can't find any chip similar. That looks similar. SM-A515, let me look at this, SM-A515, SM-A515. U1000, U1006. Just trying to find some information about that chat. So this is what's exploded, huh? Oh, thank you. Coming. Alright, so since we don't have a proper schematics for this guy, I'm gonna just move away some of the components to see if they will, if the short will go away. So let's put this guy away. The short is still there without that chip being in there, so kind of grab it with this tweezer. And that's a bad tweezer. This will have to do. Let's see if the short is still there. So that's no short. So there's our filter for what? Like, how about these guys? I guess they're all. That's fine. I see. And they're fine then. So he's fine. He's fine. That's fine. How about that guy? Is that a capacitor? Can I put this guy back somehow? Can't even get a proper home. It's very difficult. That's fine. I don't think he'll come out. I think the heat will put it back. Yeah, there we go. That one there is what I'm a little bit concerned about. Okay, so this way it can hold it for us while we measure. Yeah, there's no problem with that guy. So there isn't actually a short on the circuit. Could be that. And whatever component we just put in there, maybe that's faulty. Can't see anything, it's very hard. Okay, let's see if I can get them to settle in by reducing the airspeed. Okay, let's see if that's going to help at all. Okay, good. Okay, so now let's try another one of those chips. Okay, 685 is the location of that chip. Okay, here is another one. What the hell? Wow, really? How dodgy are these sellers? This is rubbish. Wow. This is rubbish. Yeah, this is genuine rubbish. Alright, we'll just take a photo, open a dispute. This is bizarre. No, I'm not going to use this chip. Let's get another one. I would say a little bit more to the right. You know? It's actually perfect. Just a little bit more flow. That's fine. And it is the same behavior. I wonder if there is anything else wrong with this motherboard. Alright, let's have another look at the motherboard. Okay, let's do some measurements around here. That's the inductor. That's fine. That's fine. Just checking the ground. No shorts. Okay. Is that a dead short there? Or is that just low resistance? Seven ohms. The ground is 7 ohms. That is a dead short. That does look like an inductor. That does look like an inductor. Not that guy. Yeah, that guy on that side is going somewhere. The short is on that side, unless... What? This is a jumper here. They're connected. I think that's normal. Whatever it's here is normal. That behavior is fine. I don't think there is an issue there. Are these? Yeah. This is so difficult. Shall I even open there? What am I going to find? Tricky one. All right, I'll try and get some help. Let me check the back, those guys there, see if anything fishy over there. Okay, no short there. That's gonna be ground, yeah. That's ground. No problems around there. Okay. I'll ask for some help and I'll come back. Let's finalize this Samsung. Okay. All right, here we go. Here we go. Thank God, 1.264 amps. It's interesting to have these. That's a connector. You can put a connector and speak to something. You can put a chip here, SPI, and this capacitor resistor is there. There are hidden things about these which we will never know. Data recovery is possible on these. One only has to figure out how. All right, that's that. I believe that's charging the battery. Unless the battery is shish kebab. Let's do that again. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, nothing. Volume up, volume, power, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Let's try 1, 2, 3, volume down, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here we go, something's happening. Do it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Where is this power going? Three point 3.32. All right. Let's disconnect the battery. Okay, let's cut power, go into diode mode, go here, okay. That's green. Let's add power. Where can I check the power? Maybe here? Oh, that is battery. So that's the charge controller chip. Okay, and these diodes are good. Maybe not. Reconnect the battery. Battery is connected. Let's get a voltage of the battery. Three point 3.31. What's its battery voltage rating? Four point four. Voltage 4 volts, amp 0.5, power on. Amp, let's go 1 amp. Amp. Nice. Let's see. Hey. Yes. Damn it. Charging 3 hours 20 minutes, 0%. Turning off. I will charge it fully. I'll put this wire there. My new flux arrived. I need a much thinner, smaller cable. All right, so I'm going to charge this device for a while. So I'll put this on the side and let it charge while I focus on other jobs. Somewhere where I will not touch this board. Okay. I'll put amp to 0.1. Connect that cable very carefully. Yep. Amp. One amp. Oh yeah, battery's not connected. Okay. Okay, voltage 4.4. Amp. Yep, amp 1.5. Amp 2 amp. Okay, can take more. We'll let it charge. I'll come back later on. Well, what do you know? Check this out. I'll tell you what I did. And this happened. 394 milliamps. Gonna leave that. Haven't asked for help yet. I was taking some screenshots, and then I noticed the bridge between two capacitors with the solder. I've cleared that bridge, and then I thought I'll try this. Very interesting. I'll let it be like this for some time and just see what will happen. I'll mute the audio. All right, let's just finalize this job. I suspect that chip there is not good because we're able to, I was able to charge the whole unit using the external wire method. You know, no problems, but using the Type-C cable, no. I believe the Type-C controller, the one that is provided by the company I bought it from, they're all rubbish. Original one was burnt. %81 Okay, and we connect our charger. We don't get the battery charging symbol. See that? Nothing. Even though it's all connected, and we don't get any indicator there either. Try the other way. Oh, here we go. Oh, it's now charging. Oh, my issue is fixed. So it was definitely that chip that I replaced before. Okay. Isn't that happy news? Okay, finally. All right. I'll seal this unit back and put all the everything back together. Okay, it's gonna be a messy one, eh? Alright, I'll just review the video how I open this guy. Alright, we do know it. Okay, so pretty much I think we know it. Let me see. So this guy port. That will usually stay there. One second. Okay, okay, I understand. Alright, so let's put this guy back. We're gonna remove the screen. It's been about 2 months I stopped working on this unit. Okay, let's fix up this board, put this back, this back, this back, and that's it. These three guys, remove that cable. I think that's where he went. What do you reckon? Maybe. Or no, the other way. The coil has to touch there. Okay. Okay, let's do that again. Properly mounted. Okay, that's done. Next one, the big chip. It's just a cover. It can stick on. No problem. And the other one, which will require soldering. So what is this? This will go where? Here? Yep. Okay. Feels kind of weird. Like, is that how simple it is? Did I miss anything? Looks like there is two screws. The black ones. Yeah, that's better. But that cable has to be coming out from the back of the screen. Yeah, that button is not in a good shape. We'll just have to push that button out ourselves, so okay, let's put some screws in. Okay, so it won't fall out or break into pieces. Charging the battery, all right. Maybe I didn't connect the screen properly. Okay. cable is most likely not connected properly for the screen. That's a rookie mistake. Yeah, that button is no good. Then we have to make our own. See, that's what's broken. See that? How are we gonna put that there? How are we gonna put that there now? Okay, let's try. Okay, let's try. Magic smoke, here we come. Yep, it was bound to disappear.
Okay.
What is this? This is something else, some other crap. Okay. I did it. I made my own button. Okay. So the unit works. Currently, that is. Okay. Try the camera. Yeah, Wi-Fi works too. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, a couple of them screws won't go in because the bracket for them are broken on the inside. Okay, that's about it. We're just gonna put some glue, seal that back in, and happy days, I guess. All right, let's just put some quick glue around it. I'm going to use a super glue. This guy a bit. We'll give it an alcohol wipe later. Okay, that's it. Thanks for watching. Just double check. Yeah, she's good. See you in the next one.